Hey, Packer fans, Coach Hahn here in the film room with you on behalf of PackerNet.com. I've been seeing a lot of things online and also been fielding a lot of questions about the coverages that Mike Pettine likes to run with the Green Bay secondary. Specifically, I've been seeing a lot of frustration with how easily it seems the coverages are picked apart in the shallow or the underneath game, and it seems like Pettine is playing a whole lot of safe defense. So what I'm going to try to do today for you is just explain some of these different coverages and show you their advantages and disadvantages, and then I'll just completely leave it up to you to form your own opinion whether you like it or whether you want to see something changed. So I've chosen to use the Colts game for this because there's a lot of different coverages run against a lot of different formations. So it's a really good example of just how these coverages work and should look. Okay. The first thing we're going to do is start out with the Colts combo on this. Their route tree, if you will, on this specific play. So the Colts are in doubles right on, meaning the slot receiver is on the line and the outside receiver is off the line. And then you simply have an M and an X way down here. You'll see the running back late will hit the flats, will hit a little flare route. And from this receiver, the on receiver, what we would call our H, he's going to run a wheel route, which means he's going to press up, get to the outside, and then take that vertical. And then behind him, they're going to run a shallow cross in the mesh concept. So this receiver here off the ball is going to run a shallow cross. This receiver off the ball, the slot, is going to run a divide concept, and then we'll have a long dig coming in behind it. Okay, and now what happens here is Green Bay is in what we call cover four read. And my apologies if the screen looks really busy, but there's a lot to really try to process here when it comes to coverages. Okay, so this specific coverage, cover four read, is going to have four deep defenders not allowing anything past them. They're going to play to keep everything in front of them with four, which only leaves three underneath. Okay, so this coverage is obviously weak underneath. And defenses know that, and you'll see how that comes into play in a little bit. And then it has a four-man pass rush, so a four-man pressure, if you will, or a four-man pass rush. Three underneath, four over the top. And they're running what's called quarters here, which means each one of these defenders, both safeties and both corners, are responsible for a deep quarter of the field. Nothing can get behind them. You can't give up touchdowns in this look. Okay, and then underneath, these guys have very specific jobs, starting with this outside backer, actually the nickel. He's going to play hook, which is this zone, to crosser. So anything crossing his face, like we'll see that drag route coming a little bit, he's going to have to run with that crosser. Then this inside backer plays hook to low hole, and he's going to pass off any crosser over to him. And then we have hook flat defender up here who has to run with any wheel route. Now remember, we're going to get a wheel route from this receiver right here, so he's going to have to run with that. So I'll start to play this through, and we'll start to watch how this happens. Okay, here's the wheel route forming up here. The shallow cross is coming here. We're getting the divide and the dig. You can see we're in pretty good position up here in the secondary as we're on top of everything. Right here, I would like to see this passed off a little sooner, a communication from this inside backer to this nickel saying, go attack that crosser. And what's going to happen is because he's late to the crosser, this corner right here is going to start to come off of the dig thinking he's got to go set the edge and make a play on the crosser. He's guessing that the mesh concept or this crosser route right here is going to get the ball. So this corner is going to end up coming off. And once he comes off of that just a second, all that's going to do is open up this giant dig window right in here for Pascal. Okay? So Rivers is going to see that. He's going to toss it to Pascal. That's a pretty easy pitch and catch. And then just some atrocious open field tackling from the secondary by my count. Three missed tackles, unless you count that one as a tackle, but I don't in my book. So you can see some execution errors and also a possible scheme-related error when you're playing four deep and you're allowing things to be thrown underneath you. That's up to you to decide on that, okay? But now we're going to take a little bit of a look, at just a little shakeup based on cover four read. This is a blended coverage where we're going to play cover four read on this side, the near side of the field, but then we'll play cover two up top. So this is what we call cover six, because two and four together make six, right? So we're going to play cover two up here, cover four down here, and what that allows us to do is to get four now down in this intermediate area, what we call the low deck, and three up top in the hard deck. So they've dropped one of those guys down and allowed him to play up in coverage a little bit more. And what we'll see here is very similar rules for all these guys that we saw before, quarter, quarter, hook to low hole, you know, hook to flats, rally with any crosser. However, this guy can now become a blitz peel player, which means he's going to blitz unless that running back peels out on a route, in which case he will go and cover him and abandon his blitz. And then this corner can be a jam funnel player, which means he can get up here, be aggressive, throw some timing off, and funnel any deep route he gets to this safety right here. Okay, so that's how it's going to look. And the Packers, do an excellent job of executing this. You can see everything peel off. We're going to get to this crosser late. We've got our three deep right here, right here. We've got a deep half with our jam and carry player. Going to go ahead and funnel that right to the safety. You can see we got a blitz peel coming here, and we've got a low hole that's going to go Rob here pretty soon. So Rivers is taking a look at it, gets the pass rush in his face, and now he has to abandon ship, break the pocket. He'll eventually throw this away. So that's very well done by the Packers, playing some cover six as a changeup to cover four. The next play we're going to take a look at is still cover six, but I want you to take a look at this defender right here. Unfortunately, for whatever reason, he doesn't do a very good job on his drop, and I'll show you just how finite coverage is, just how small mistakes can turn into big things. So again, we're in cover six, which means everybody on this side of the field is playing cover two. Everybody on this side of the field is playing cover four. So you're going to get a deep bail here, a deep bail here, a deep bail here. We're allowed to play some underneath stuff here and here. And this should go right to the flats right here underneath number one receiver. And then we can bracket this out to take away any of these little snag routes here. Okay, so keeping your eye on this defender, on that nickel defender right here, he should be getting shallow into the flats as number one makes his break. So you can see number one start to go vertical, and he's still widening out. When number one is stopping, he's still going vertical, which is a no-no because we have a vertical player right here for you. There's coverage over the top. You, instead of getting vertical, this nickel has to get underneath this route and completely take it away. Because he's still dropping vertical, now you have two dudes over the top of one and nobody in between him and the ball, which is a coverage error. That's a bad problem because now it's an easy pitch and catch, and it's a pickup of probably 12 or 13 on what was second and 13. So that's not a very good job by that nickel. It's a good call in my opinion, and you can form your own, but to me, that's not a good job by that nickel. Now, one of the things I keep hearing over and over again is Pettine needs to get more aggressive. We got to get dudes up in their grill. We got to bring more pressure. As with everything, there are pros and cons to that. Obviously, it makes the ball come out quicker. However, the cons are a lot greater with going with some man pressure or jam man, because if that pass rush doesn't get home or somebody doesn't do their job in the secondary, it becomes a big gain quick. So the Colts are in empty right here. We're going to see five man across the board. This is what we call man cover one, because everybody here is in man coverage all the way across the board. And we're going to keep a single high safety right here just in case one of these dudes get beat. We have somebody that can hopefully possibly stop the touchdown. Okay, the problem with man coverage is if you get any sort of inside release, you're going to run for a long ways. So the Colts here are in fourth and four. This is a fourth down set, and they're going to steal a play right out of the Packers playbook that the Packers love to run in the red zone. We're going to get a little stick concept here where we got a dig coming in, what we call a drive route, and then we have a wheel basing off of it just to run this guy off and hope to hold the attention of the safety, get a little stick route underneath it. But Rivers isn't even going to look the trip side in empty. What he's going to go to is up here, a little stutter slip route combo that we call, where this on receiver is going to go stutter in front of this cornerback and then slip. And what that's going to do is set a nice little natural pick for this receiver who's off the ball and can't get jammed to slip right underneath it. And as we watch this play develop, it's very well timed by the Colts. You'll see that little stutter right here, but he never actually initiates contact, so it's not a pick route, it's not pass interference. He just gets in the way of that corner enough, and the problem with man coverage is if you get an inside release, that thing's going to go for a long way. That's why we can get, you know, 15 yards or so on fourth and four, okay? And then a good open field tackle saves a touchdown. The safety's over the top of it, but it's still a fourth down conversion. So my whole goal was to just kind of explain some of these coverages. And again, I've touched on maybe a tenth of the coverages that especially NFL teams like to run. So just a few, but to just show you some of the pros and some of the cons and how it's now the defensive coordinator's job to make those coverage calls in different game scenarios. So again, my name is Coach Hahn in the film room for Packernet.com. Let me know your thoughts on this. Let me know whether you think Pettine is too passive or possibly too aggressive or just right, and I'll hopefully brew up a video for you coming soon. Otherwise, take care. Have a great day.